गुड मॉर्निंग. टुडे आई विल डिस्कस द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ स्टेडी फ्लो एनर्जी इक्वेशन. इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द वेरियस टाइप ऑफ द applications such as boiler, turbine and nozzle. So in the case of different devices such as turbine, boiler and nozzle, already I have discussed the three applications and applied the steady flow energy equation. In the turbine, we calculate the net work output W is equal to H1 minus H2. In the boiler, we calculate the total heat, because we know that from the boiler we generate the steam, and how much is the quality of the heat, that is to be calculated by the boiler. And in the nozzle, we calculate the velocity of the steam and exit. Now, today I will discuss rest of applications such as condenser, evaporator, compressor and centrifugal pump. So these are the basic devices from which we apply the steady flow energy equation. So one by one we discuss about how the equation becomes, in the case of condenser, in the case of evaporator such as compressor as well as centrifugal pump. So while we write the any equation according to steady flow energy equation, you must have to write first the basic approach, the basic law of the steady flow energy equation. So by first, now today I will discuss these types of the applications regarding steady flow energy equation. So here condenser, the fourth one is already three I have discussed earlier video, turbine, boiler and nozzle. Now today that is condenser. First of all, we have to know that what is condenser and what it is role in the thermodynamics. Basically, all of you know or heard about the term condenser. Basically, this is a device which are used in a fan. All of you know. But in the thermodynamics, the word condenser, which condenses the steam and convert into the one phase to the another phase. So while passing through the surface of the turbine blade, that the some steam must be extracted from the turbine surfaces, and after passing through the turbine surface, then the steam quality becomes heat, and when it passes through the condenser, here water in, this one is water out. जब भी condenser medium में जो steam pass होती है, तो it convert steam into the form of water. So always be noted that condenser is a device which are used to convert the steam into the form of water. So here the basic figure of the condenser is as such. This figure can be drawn in such a way. one is, you can write here, control volume. Suppose that this one is not water, you can do pipe. Water goes inside, in this place, water in, and here the not water in, you can write here steam. Either water in, steam out, either steam in, water out. So one phase of the transformation converted into the another phase. Steam in, and here this one is steam, not steam, water out. Here coolant in, coolant in, here coolant. So this is the basic function of the condenser, in which the coolant inside the pipe and outside, it becomes the coolant out and the steam goes inside and it becomes into the form of water. So we apply the steady flow energy equation according to steady flow energy equation. Steady flow energy equation के according generally जो हमने formula use किया है as such h1 plus v1 square by 2 plus gz1 plus 2 is equal to h2 plus v2 square by 2 plus gz2 plus w. In the condenser, that there are no work done in the condenser, so it may be right as work done W is equal to 0, datum heads equal datum head, Z1 is equal to Z2, work done is 0, datum head Z1 is equal to Z2. Heat transfer, it means that the net heat transfer, because the steam changes from liquid to steam to liquid, so phase change, so Q is in negative. So always we consider that while we generate the equation, that Q must be is in negative direction. So putting all these values in the equation and generate the equation H1 plus V1 is equal to V2. H1 plus Q जो है वो minus में है, so H1 minus 2 is equal to H2. So in this equation, Q may be right here, that value is equal to Q H1 plus Q is equal to W is 0, Q is in negative. So H1 minus H2, that is equal to Q. So in the condenser, net gain, that is equal to the H1 minus H2. Now, the next video is application of condenser. First of all, we have to know that what is condenser. Generally, this is used in maximum cases in the thermodynamics, such as gas turbine, as well as in Rankine cycle, as well as in production of steam, that the this figure is compression. So condenser and compressor both plays an important role in a thermodynamics, because generally these devices are applicable in Rankine cycle, in power plant generation, and into the application of compression to compress the air from low pressure air to the hot pressure air, because it is used also in the refrigeration and air conditioning, because compression is used to compress the steam from low pressure to a high pressure. So it compresses steam as well as air. So here we discuss about the topic compression. So this figure is a schematic of compressor. Here air in the fresh air that passes through the inlet chamber in the environment, a huge amount of air is to be placed there. So the air is passing through this chamber, and after this that the air is compressed at a pressure and temperature, and then it is passes from outside, and this compressed air and pressure, that its intensity is very high, so it can be used and maintain a huge pressure. So in the compressor, again we apply according to steady flow energy equation. According to steady flow energy equation, H1 plus V1 square by 2 plus GZ1 plus Q is equal to H2 plus V2 square by 2 plus GZ2 plus W. This is the steady flow energy equation. Here potential energy and kinetic energy are negligible, because its value is very small, so it may be neglected. Determinant is equal to Z1 is equal to Z2. In the compressor, in point to be remembered, in the compressor, both work done and heat transfer on the system, so Q and W considered in negative. We know that when the work done and heat both are transferred, that work done on the compressor and heat is transferred on the compressor, so it may be considered as negative. So put here, according to steady flow energy equation, H1 plus Q, and Q only negative here, H1 minus Q is equal to H2 minus W. Because here Q is negative, W is negative, both data head are equal, Z1 is equal to Z2, V1 square or V2 square. Both inlet and exit velocity that are very small, so it can be neglected. So from this compression equation, because H2 minus Q is equal to H2 minus W, from this we can write H1 minus H2 is equal to Q minus W. So this equation is for the compression. So for any device, for applying the steady flow energy equation, we must have to know that which quantity is to be zero or which quantity is not to be required for the particular devices. In the turbine, no heat is required, so Q is equal to V0. For the compressor, both Q and W will be negative for the case of before we discussed, that is condenser where one gun is zero, evaporator again the network gun is zero. So step by step we need to remember that which quantity is to be zero and which quantity is to be negligible. So from this we can write the compression. In the university exam generally it is asked to write the expression for the steady flow energy equation and write the steady flow energy equation for the case of turbine or boiler. So according to the seven fundamental devices, compressor, turbine, boiler, condenser, evaporator, centrifugal pump, two or three devices must be asked in the university exam. So we have to remember, because it is very simple to how to apply the steady flow energy equation. Okay, so now next we discuss about the evaporator. This is number 5. Fourth pe aapka condenser. Okay, now we discuss about evaporator. Now the rest two devices is, one is the evaporator and another one is the centrifugal pump. Now we discuss about evaporator. Generally evaporator is a long vent pipe from which the refrigerant passes by this small vent pipe. So generally this device coolant in refrigerant in refrigerant. The figure of the evaporator. This device are used into the refrigeration from which that it passes through the refrigerant from one place to the another place. Another way that the evaporator that converts the low pressure of refrigerant into the high pressure refrigerant to the long vent pipe. So again according to the steady flow energy equation, H1 plus U1 square by 2 plus GZ1 plus Q is equal to H2 plus U2 square by 2 plus GZ2 plus W. This is the steady flow energy equation. Here for the case of for evaporator, potential energy and kinetic energy are negligible. One ton W is equal to 0. Data units are equal, that one is equal to Z2. Put all these values in the equation. So here H1 plus Q is equal to H2. W is 0 because in the case of evaporator, W value becomes 0. So for this, Q is equal to H2 minus H1. So this is the case for evaporator. And generally evaporator is used into the refrigerator, which is a long vent pipe from which the coolant is passes from through a tube from one side to the another side. The last, that is centrifugal pump. So basically the pump is two types and the main function of the pump is to deliver the water from low level side to high level side and vice versa, that it transfer from high head to the low head. So generally we use everywhere the pump that is installed in such a place where water supply from low level to the high level, and similarly the water required from high level to low level. So there are two types of pump. One is the centrifugal pump and another one is the reciprocating pump. So here generally we discuss about the centrifugal pump, from which the low level side the water is to be extracted and it transferred to the high level head. So this is the schematic diagram for the centrifugal pump, from where this is a water storage into the earth. The water is to be extracted by the pump. The pump extracts the water from the ground level and it transferred to a reservoir. Reservoir is a device from which that it stores the water. So receiver or the reservoir that it collects the water. So this is the pump, centrifugal pump. So here again we apply the steady flow energy equation. So seventh, this one is the centrifugal pump. So for this case, according to steady flow energy equation, H1 plus V1 square by 2 plus GZ1 plus Q is equal to H2 plus V2 square by 2 plus GZ2 plus W. देखो, सात डिवाइसेस के बारे में हमने स्टडी फ्लो एनर्जी इक्वेशन लिखा और सातों जगह यही इक्वेशन हमने लिखा. तो जनरली आपको याद हो जाना चाहिए कि स्टडी फ्लो एनर्जी इक्वेशन क्या है और इसका डेरिवेशन. सो फॉर सेंट्रीफ्यूगल पंप देयर आर नो हीट रिक्वायर्ड. हीट क्यू इज इक्वल टू 0 वर्क डन ऑन द सिस्टम. It may consider negative and H1 is equal to the H2. So according to this equation, V1 square by 2, H1 is equal to H2, this is cancel out, V1 square by 2 plus GZ1 is equal to V2 square by 2 plus GZ2 minus W. Q is equal to net transfer of it is 0, so here minus W. So how much the work is obtained from the centrifugal pump? It can be right here. W is equal to V2 square minus V1 square by 2 plus GZ2 minus Z1. So this is the case for centrifugal pump while applying the steady flow energy equation. So these are the devices where we apply the different for different devices, we apply the steady flow energy equation. Now, from this equation, we can solve a numerical regarding steady flow energy equation. We always use this formula. जो टर्म दिया है, डाटा में दिया होगा, उस चीज़ को हम पहले फाइंड आउट कर लेंगे, उसके बाद जो न्यू टर्म है उसको हम निकाल लेंगे और फिर हम इस फॉर्मूले का यूज करके न्यूमेरिकल सॉल्व कर लेंगे. तो अगर एग्जाम में स्टेडी फ्लो एनर्जी इक्वेशन का एप्लीकेशन नहीं पूछा जाता है तो जनरली इसके जो न्यूमेरिकल्स हैं वो जरूर से हैं. तो चाहे आपका कोई भी दो पार्ट डिवाइस का स्टेडी फ्लो एनर्जी इक्वेशन एप्लीकेशन लगा के इक्वेशन बनाने को पूछे या इस पे न्यूमेरिकल. सो अब हम इसका नेक्स्ट में जो न्यूमेरिकल है उसको लेकर डिस्कस करेंगे. ओके, न्यूमेरिकल अकॉर्डिंग टू द स्टेडी फ्लो एनर्जी इक्वेशन द न्यूमेरिकल इज अ टर्बाइन operating under steady flow energy. Steady flow energy receive 4500 kg of steam per hour. The steam enters the turbine at a velocity of the steam enters in the turbine at a velocity of an elevation of 5.5 meter and a specific enthalpy of of 2800 kg per kilogram, which leaves the turbine at a velocity of meter per minute and elevation of 1.5 meter and specific enthalpy kg per kilogram. Heat loss from the turbine is heat loss from the turbine is 1600 kg per hour. So this is the Newton according to स्टेडी फ्लो एनर्जी इक्वेशन. देखने में ये न्यूमेरिकल जो है वो लेंथ वाइज आपको थोड़ा लंबा लगेगा, बट इसका जो सलूशन है वो कंपेरेटिवली बहुत इजी है. तो इसके न्यूमेरिकल को हम कैसे सॉल्व करें, इसके लिए बेसिकली जो जो टर्म दिया है, ए टर्बाइन ऑपरेटिंग अंडर स्टेडी फ्लो एनर्जी रिसीव 4500 kg ऑफ स्टीम पर आवर. जो हीट है वो रिसीव हो रहा है 4500 kg per hour. अब जनरली जो पर आवर में है हम उसको पर सेकंड में लेंगे, दैट हीट इज इक्वल टू 4500 kg per hour. सो मास फ्लो रेट 4500 kg, ये मास ऑफ स्टीम 60 × 60, दिस वन इज इन सेकंड. तो इसकी वैल्यू होगी सॉल्व करने पे, दैट वैल्यू इज इक्वल टू 1.25 kg per second. सो मास फ्लो रेट इज 1.25 kg per second. द स्टीम एंटर्स इन द टर्बाइन एट ए वेलोसिटी ऑफ, किस वेलोसिटी से एंटर कर रही है, 2800 मीटर पर मिनट. इसको अगर हम सेकंड में बदलेंगे तो 2800 मीटर बाय 60, दैट इज दैट वैल्यू बिकम्स बाय सॉल्विंग दिस 46.67 मीटर पर सेकंड. V1, द स्टीम एंटर्स इन द टर्बाइन एट ए वेलोसिटी ऑफ 2800 मीटर पर मिनट एंड एलिवेशन Z1 इज इक्वल टू 5.5 मीटर एंड स्पेसिफिक एंथैल्पी H1 is 2800 kg per kilogram and leaves at this point. अगर हम इसको डायग्राम से इंडिकेट करें, ये इनलेट कंडीशन है, इनलेट कंडीशन, और ये जो है वो एग्जिट कंडीशन है. स्टीम जो है वो यहाँ से पास होके इस साइड बाहर जा रही है, तो यहाँ पे जो वैल्यूज दिया है एंथैल्पी आपका वेलोसिटी और जो एग्जिट पे है दोनों को हम लिख लेते हैं। दीज आर फॉर इनलेट कंडीशंस, एग्जिट कंडीशंस पे जो वैल्यूज है द टर्बाइन विच लीव द टर्बाइन एट वेलोसिटी ऑफ v2 इज इक्वल टू 5600 मीटर पर मिनट, इसको हम सेकेंड में बदलेंगे तो 5600 मीटर बाय 60। बाय सॉल्विंग दिस वी गेट v2 इज इक्वल टू, वी कैन राइट z2 h2 एंड मीटर पर सेकेंड। z2 elevation of 1.5 meter, vector is 1.5 meter, specific enthalpy h2 is 2300, heat loss from the turbine is minus 1600 loss, kg per hour is for kg per second delay 60 into 60, that value is equal to q, that becomes 4.44। यहाँ पे जो फाइंड आउट करना है अगेन रीड द कैलकुलेटर, व्हाइल ऑपरेटिंग अंडर स्टैटिक फ्लो एनर्जी रिसीव 4500 केजी ऑफ स्टीम पर आवर, द स्टीम एंटर्स इन द टर्बाइन एट अ वेलोसिटी ऑफ 2800 मीटर पर मिनट, elevation of 5.5 meter and specific enthalpy of this which leave the turbine and elevation is this, heat loss from the turbine is this. So here we have to calculate the, you have to mention over, calculate the work done. Now Newton ne pad liya hai, ek bar given data likh diya hai, so it can be erased. According to again जो हमने applications के लिए दिया था equation, according to the steam equation, according to the steady flow energy equation h1 plus v1 square by 2 plus gz1 plus 2 is equal to h2 plus v2 square by 2 plus gz2 plus this is the static flow energy equation. Values जो put हैं उसको हम एक साइड में रखेंगे, जो वैल्यू दिया है वो सेकेंड साइड में रखेंगे, तो putting the value of h1 दिया है, v1 दिया है, z1 और z2 दिया है, यहाँ पे q दिया है और हमें w की वैल्यू फाइंड आउट करनी है, तो putting all these values in the equation, h1 is 2800 plus v1 square by 2 250 by 6 v1 square by 2 plus 9.81 into 5.5 is equal to 2300 plus 93.33 v1 square by 2 plus 9.81 into 1.5 plus W. Heat loss भी यहाँ पे दिया है, वैल्यू टू की वैल्यू पुट कर सकते हैं हम, दैट वैल्यू इज माइनस 4.44 या जनरली हम केजी पर आवर में रख रहे हैं सर, तो 1600 केजी पर आवर। सो हियर बाय सॉल्विंग दिस यू गेट द रिजल्ट, द नेट वर्क डन So here we make a practice how to fit the value into the steady flow energy equation. So one by one here we put the values simultaneously and we put all the terms according to the given equation discuss a very important topic, that is throttling process. Throttling kya hai? The word throttling that comes from the word throttle. It is a ball. Throttling, जो word है वो throttle से है, या हम इसको कह सकते हैं throat. तो throat का काम meaning होता है गला. तो whenever the requirement of voice, then it outside the voice, and when the requirement doesn't require, so we can stop speaking. So throttling process, whenever the supply of the food is to be required, then it is to be controlled by a plug. So this, it is an irreversible process. Throttling process is an irreversible process in which a fluid flowing across a restriction undergoes a drop in pressure without changing enthalpy. Suppose that this is a pipe where the fluid is passing across this. This is the wall where we can stop the flow of the steam by throttle wall. So there are the friction in between the pipe surface and the steam which is flowing into the pipe. So it is an irreversible process. While the steam is passing through the pipe, then there are the friction occurs in between the surface of the pipe and for the steam. It is an irreversible process in which a fluid flowing across a restriction means this, undergoes a drop in pressure without changing enthalpy. Pressure जरूर drop होगा, because suppose करिए कि कोई water अगर flow में आ रहा है और अचानक से हम उसके ऊपर एक restriction लगाते हैं, कोई एक barrier लगाते हैं जिसके through वो पानी रुक जाए, तो पानी की speed तो starting में बहुत तेज है, लेकिन जैसे ही हम barrier लगाएं उसकी जो total प्रेशर था वो डिक्रीज हो गया, प्रेशर ड्रॉप हो गया, लेकिन जो उसकी एंथैल्पी है वो चेंज होगी, बिकॉज इनलेट पे और एग्जिट पे देयर आर द नो चेंज ऑफ एंथैल्पी, ओनली द प्रेशर विल बी ड्रॉप. सो द थ्रॉटलिंग प्रोसेस, इट इज एन इरिवर्सिबल प्रोसेस वेयर इन द रिस्ट्रिक्शन द प्रेशर ड्रॉप मस्ट बी अकर बट द एंथैल्पी नेवर बी चेंज. सो बाय दिस प्रिंसिपल we can write here again according to steady flow energy equation. We can write h1 plus v1 squared by 2 plus gz1 plus q is equal to h2 plus v2 squared by 2 plus gz2 plus w. This is the steady flow energy equation. In this equation, here H1, potential energy, and kinetic energy are like negligible. V1 is equal to V2, Z1 is equal to Z2. So, according to this equation, we can write this H1 plus 0 is equal to the H2 plus 0. H1 plus 0 is equal to H2 plus 0, either H1 is equal to H2. So we can write here enthalpy before throttling. Is equal to the enthalpy after throttling. This is the basic principle of the throttling, that H1 is remain same to the H1 is equal to the H2 enthalpy at inlet section. This is the inlet, this is the exit. Suppose that here pressure is P1, velocity is V1, enthalpy is H1. Here, exit pressure P2, velocity V2, enthalpy is H2. So these are the deviations that are used at the inlet and exit conditions while we write the throttling process. That the point must be remembered that for the irreversible process, in the pressure drops must be occur because the restriction phenomena takes place while the restriction occurs, but the enthalpy remains same at inlet and exit condition. So here the statement can be proved by writing the steady flow energy equation and put all the terms according to this, and we solve the particular analytical approach and we got H1 is equal to H2, so enthalpy before throttling is equal to the enthalpy after throttling. So in this video we discussed only that the applications of the steady flow energy equation, how to solve the numerical. You have much to practice about the steady flow energy equation, how the values is to be write into the equations, check the unit and conversion in appropriate manner according to the unit positions and different positions, and then discuss the throttling process. So here we discuss all these three important topics. Tomorrow we discuss the laws of thermodynamics and perpetual motion. Okay, thank you.